So let us say when you have arthritis or tendinitis, your doctor might recommend you to get a cortisone injection into the joint or around the tendon to get pain relief. But let us say if you have diabetes, what side effects can the cortisone injection cause? We're going to find out in this video.
So in patients without any diabetes, I'm not so much worried about the blood sugar concerns, but let's say if the patient has diabetes, especially with patients with uncontrolled diabetes, these steroids can actually increase their blood sugar significantly. So, and the other concern is that, so most of the time, let's say I see a patient with an A1C, which is the average blood sugar for 3 months. So let's say the A1C is like 8 or 9. So that means that it's an uncontrolled diabetes. And these patients might be prone for tendinitis. For example, they could have like a shoulder pain from rotator cuff tendinitis or tendinopathy, or they could have a frozen shoulder. So during this, in this scenario, I would really focus on getting the blood sugar under control, because one, the steroids can increase the blood sugar. And the other thing is that the tendinitis or the frozen shoulder could have come because of the high blood sugar. And what happens is that when you have a high blood sugar, these forms a glycation end product. So basically think about these sugar molecules that go and link into the tendon structures or any type of tissue structures that cause the inflammation. So sometimes just focusing on getting the blood sugar under control might actually help their inflammation around the joint or inflammation on the tendon far more than just putting in a steroid injection and then causing the blood sugar to go high. So let us say if you were to get the steroid injection and you have diabetes, it's very hard to predict how much time the steroids are going to affect your blood sugar. So sometimes it might be anywhere between 1 to 2 weeks, and sometimes even more than that. So that's why, let's say if someone is insulin, I usually don't change their insulin regimen. I probably would give them a correction factor insulin. So basically what I say is that, so let's say if your blood sugar is like more than 150 or more than 200, then give an extra units of insulin. So this is something that you might have to discuss with the doctor when you consider getting this injection. So let us say if you see a doctor like me, like a family medicine doctor, along with a sports medicine specialty, then I can actually adjust your blood sugar at the same time, give the injection. But let's say if you see an orthopedician who is going to do the injection, then I would say like you have to contact your primary care doctor who can adjust your insulin accordingly.
I hope this video is helpful. If you have any questions, please post in the comments below, and I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.